L'intelligence artificielle, c'est un peu une somme d'un modèle mathématique qui est extrêmement avancé, qui permet de, en d'autres mots, d'extraire certaines tendances qui sont normalement pas nécessairement identifiables par l'œil humain. C'est pas nécessairement quelque chose qui est discernable de façon très immédiate. Donc, c'est beaucoup une étude de relations entre différents points de données qui sont normalement un peu dispares.
AI, generally speaking, is a broad domain or a domain within computer science where the idea is for the computers to think, sense, and then further act based on what they have thought and arrive to a decision.
So I think one of the biggest advantages for the government of Canada is to allow the human expertise that you have today within government to be more effective in order to ensure that the work that you're doing is appropriately set for the level of interest and the level of understanding that exists today in the market. It allows you to take processes that are maybe a little bit not as critical, doesn't have as much need for human expertise, and it allows you to take that information and manage it through technology, giving you the opportunity to have your key resources and your key government members to do the work that's most relevant.
In terms of leading the charge in academic research, in amount of startups and companies and talent interested in AI is at the very top. So Canada is really doing great. United States has probably more researchers, but only because they are more people. But I think that if you do the density in Canada, the density will be higher.
Du point de vue du secteur public en général, c'est que ça va permettre de vraiment gagner beaucoup, non seulement du point de vue de la qualité des services qui sont donnés, mais encore plus de ça, avoir plus de connaissances, une meilleure compréhension de la population que les services publics doivent desservir. Puis à penser vraiment encore plus loin que ça, je dirais que c'est quelque chose qui va être bénéfique pour l'industrie, pas juste l'industrie du secteur public, mais vraiment l'industrie mondiale. C'est essentiellement une nouvelle révolution industrielle, pas nécessairement du point de vue du degré de l'automation, mais plutôt du degré de la qualité du travail et de l'accélération des processus humains.
When it comes to AI, there are two main things. You either reduce cost or increase revenue. In the case of the government of Canada, I think we can do both. In one side, you can reduce costs by making automatic certain tasks that right now takes a lot of time. So I think that we need to see this as a way to advance as a country towards services that we never had the time to do because we were focused in very automatic and simple tasks. So let's AI do that. So that's one thing. In terms of generate revenue, for example, in the case where we can quickly analyze the impact of regulations, we can move forward with the law much faster. And the consequence of this is that we allow Canada to innovate and grow much more.
I think the one message that I really like to add is that to ensure that people understand when you think about AI, when you think about technology, what's really critical is the amount of training that is necessary for that information. The amount of expertise that's necessary in order to ensure that the data is well trained and without bias. So one of the biggest issues with AI technology today is the management of bias and how do we ensure that the data that is being analyzed is void of any specific bias. And that's something that's really important for how we manage information today and how we'll manage information in the future.
A broader aspect of AI is beyond regulations, the way it goes, is cybersecurity as an example. The ability for our government and for its citizens to protect from malicious attacks. AI will be an enabler for the Canadian government for it to move towards more open and a digital government.
On est déjà rendu ici. Mais de plus loin encore que ça, savoir que du jour au lendemain, en utilisant des technologies à développement et déploiement rapide, on est capable de faire bouger les choses encore plus vite. On peut aller rejoindre l'avenir tellement plus rapidement en utilisant l'intelligence artificielle.